just invented. Gary's new album drops this weekend, Trouble in Love, and I suspect we may hear some cuts from that. I certainly hope so. I've been listening to it on a daily basis ever since they've been dropping tracks out there, of course, to tease us all. So we got there to be able to watch with the other artists and work shape. One of the things that's fun is a lot of the artists this weekend were able to stick around and see other artists, which is always a treat for us. They have the time and interest to do that. Anyway, would you please welcome to the 15-day Roots and Earth Festival, Miss Mary Gershon.
Two of you and one don't feel. I don't know which one is real. his best to play his real song. So this one was sung on the show by a character named Avery. The gentleman's real name is Jonathan Jackson, and I love what he did with it. This is called How You Learn to Live Alone, written with the great Gretchen Peter, who is going to be on Charlie's next training trip.
Thank you.
she didn't get mad. She didn't even cry. She lit a cigarette. She said goodbye. I must have missed the sign. I missed a turn somewhere. I looked in her eyes. CD table, I always go to the table and sign stuff, talk to folks at the end of the show, and I could see from the corner of my eye a guy was kind of waiting, and I knew he wanted to talk to me. And so I just kind of kept my eye on him, and as the line went down, he approached me, and he puts his hands on the table, and looks at me, that song. Thank you. started in romance. Let me explain something to you. There's a house two doors down from Wit's End. It's called We're Home. And you push somebody past their wit's end, you might end up there with them. And sadly, I expect you'll probably think about me at this moment when you get there. Because there ain't no coming back from that. All right, so I have been blessed with so many things. The last couple of months have been incredible for me. I think it's been the best few months of my journey as a person, really. I don't know what's happening. You know, sometimes it's like, it sucks. Or it's boring. But this has been, oh my God, day after day. One of the incredible things that has occurred is that I was invited to do this work called Songwriting with Soldier.
Yeah.
Songwriter in Austin, Texas, named Darden Smith. You probably know Darden.
Yeah.
Darden wrote a song with Radley Foster called Angel Flight. If you haven't heard the song, just text yourself right now. Angel Flight. Go to YouTube after this or now, I don't care. check it out. It is an amazing song. Songs are so powerful, they can change your destiny. It's amazing. It's just amazing, the power of these things. That's why Woody Guthrie's machine said, this machine kills fascists. It's a powerful thing. It pisses off presidents. Just remember how it looked up. Richard Nixon got about John Lennon. These are powerful machines. So Darden wrote Angel Flight, Darden and Radley, and the universe saw it fit to have them start working with soldiers. And it pushed him into it, really. He has a beautiful way of describing how it happened. He started an organization called Songwriting with Soldiers, and things have just been put in place for him to keep going with it. Corporate sponsors, private donors. And what he does, he pairs up professional songwriters with combat veterans. And when I had the chance to do it a few weeks ago, there were 4 songwriters and 15 female combat veterans. Most of them had been soldiers in Iraq and Afghanistan. We had one that had served in Vietnam. And we had literally a day and a half with them. The opportunity is free for soldiers. So if you know any soldiers who are willing to take a risk, this is not natural for a soldier to do, by the way. They don't want to talk about it, particularly to non-soldiers. It just isn't something that soldiers do, and that's not going to change. But because of the magic of this piece of wood, these strings, the songwriters were able to get soldiers to start talking. And mostly we did it with 2 soldiers and 1 songwriter, so they could talk to each other, and we were just listening and trying to catch what it is they were saying. And so at the end of a day and a half, we managed to have written 15 songs. And we had a little concert for the soldiers, and they wept, and I wept. And it was very powerful. And I look forward to doing a whole lot more of that work. The soldiers came in with an attitude of, where's the free massage? That's kind of how you trick them in. Songwriting with soldiers, free massage. the soldiers are fed and their accommodations are free, and Darden works out to get them there and get them home. No cost to the soldiers. That's all sponsored by outside people. The soldiers eventually are like, I'm not sure about this kumbaya. But boy, when they start talking, they can't stop. They can't stop. It's so beautiful. It's so powerful. And it just feels like the right use of the songwriting gift to work with people who've been through trauma. So my second song I wrote with this woman named Brandy, a beautiful African-American woman, with dreads that she manages to twist into this bun that she wraps in colorful fabric and beautiful makeup, the fingernails manicured to the T, flowing dress, just a very gorgeous young woman. Yeah, remember, these are young people. Most all of them are under 30. And she was gorgeous. And I asked Brandy, we sat down for the, you know, the talking part, trying to get a song with her. I said, well, which branch of the service did you serve in? And she said, I was Army. I'm like, damn, you don't look Army to me. Sort of looked like beauty school. Service had beauty school? She said, nope, I was Army. I said, what'd you do in the Army? She said, I was a small engine mechanic. In the Army, small engine mechanics work on 15-ton vehicles. 15-ton and below. Man, that's not very small. She goes, not really. I said, how many women were mechanics with you? She said, one. So she and one other woman served as a mechanic in Iraq. And I did my best to capture her story. And it goes like this. When I refuse. see his friend behind his lighter's flame. Now that same frown's in my mirror, I got my daddy's blood inside my veins. Fish swim, birds fly, daddy's so bad alone here. Don't bother.